I want to give you a huge congratulations for completing the complete digital marketing course. Not everybody is going to get to the end of a big course like this, so really congratulate yourself for putting in the effort and following through. I hope by now you have really gained new skills and you have implemented the strategies that you've learned in this course. Personally, for me to carry out those 12 projects myself was tough. I really did have to push through. So if you're feeling like you need a bit of an extra push, trust me, it's really worth investing the time and implementing all of this stuff because the results do really pay off and a lot of competitors will not push past the point where you are now. Let's quickly recap on what you have learned in this course. I'll briefly go back over all of these sections and pick out one or two of the major takeaways just to wrap up. All right, let's get straight into it. Now let's look at the course notes and I'm gonna pick out one key takeaway from each section of the course. If you remember nothing else from the entire section, this would be the thing that I recommend you do and implement because it will have the biggest impact on your marketing results and really help you grow so much faster. I know that it takes time to implement this stuff, so I'm really narrowing it down for you to really help you get the best results. The first main takeaway comes from the first section we really looked at, which was the marketing plan section of the course where you created your first marketing plan. And if there's only one thing that I would really recommend you do is that to develop a buyer persona. The very first question that we had in this course is what is marketing? First part of that is who is your customer? This is where marketing really starts. If you don't know who your customer is, then how can you understand what their pain points are? If you don't know what their pain points are, how can you really provide solutions that they are going to want to take you up on and really ultimately then help you build your business and grow a lot faster? So it all ties back to the buyer persona. This is where marketing starts. This is where business opportunities start. You really need to understand who they are and what really is holding them back, what is struggling for them. I showed you here my examples. I also gave you some tips in terms of developing your buyer persona to really have a look in the mirror. If you've identified a problem, some frustration that you think needs fixing, it's probably because you're your buyer persona, somebody just like you. As well as that, I gave you the PDF to really fill in and answer all those questions. And then finally as well, I included this bonus lecture down the end, really 7 ways to find your audience online. If you're having some trouble identifying who your buyer persona is and their pain points, I gave you these 7 tips to use Quora. This is fantastic because people are really asking questions. They're saying what their problems are. So it's great to go in there and see those questions. You can also find top blogs in Google. What are the articles that they are posting that have been most popular? You can use similarweb.com to see where your competitors are getting their most amount of traffic, their countries, the sources, and that'll really help you locate where your buyer persona is online. You can use the Keyword Everywhere tool to search, get that search volume, and Reddit, online marketplaces, Facebook groups, they're all ways that you can find your audience. So in terms of developing a marketing plan, this is where it all starts. It's down to developing a buyer persona, and that's the one key takeaway from this section of the course. Now, in the next section of the course, we looked at market research and really gathering priceless feedback and emails with Typeform online surveys. And the one key takeaway that I would really recommend for you, if you want to get results out of surveys and in marketing in general, is to solve their problems, not your problems. And the way that you even approach this survey and distributing it, I think will really give you a lesson about how you should approach marketing in general. So coming down to really distributing the Typeform survey, I made a point here really about the way that you approach this and distribute this. You're only going to have an email subject line or a post title in a Facebook group to really catch people's attention. And so often what I see is people send emails saying, can you help me? Can you take a few minutes to fill this out? As if they want to solve their problems, they want me to solve their problems rather than them solving my problems. So they've got it the wrong way around. And really, that's not how you want to approach your marketing at all. You want to always communicate to the customer that you're solving their problems. And so a much better way, instead of can you take a few minutes to answer this survey, is I'm making a new course for you and I'd love your input. This will get a lot more responses as you're really reminding people that you're there to help, and there's a clear benefit for them and an incentive for them to really respond. So that's, I think, a little lesson on how you should approach marketing at a high level, but even tying this back to the survey, that's how you're going to get much better results. So the second takeaway is really to solve their problems, not your problems. Now, takeaway number three comes from the WordPress section of the course, where you created your own WordPress website in just 5 steps. And from this section of the course, if there's just one thing that would make the biggest impact to your marketing and your success online, that would be to really get a premium WordPress theme. So I included this as a bonus lecture, like an option, but I think if you're really serious, you should go ahead and get yourself a premium theme. I bought the Schema theme from my theme shop for this website, and I hope you think that it looks pretty good. It definitely, for me, makes my site look more professional, more trustworthy, and that is what a small investment of $50, $60 can do. Think of the long-term impact of that trust and credibility from a $50, $60 investment. The payoff is just absolutely massive, so if you're looking for somewhere where you can get a big return on your investment, this is the place to do it. People will really make a decision on what they think of your business just by the design and the way it looks. It's not necessarily fair, but it's just the way that we are designed to think. We don't have time to process all of the facts, and so appearance is a big consideration in terms of how we value things. So that's the third takeaway from this course, really get yourself a premium theme. Next up, we had the fourth takeaway, which is from the email marketing section of the course. And if there's just one thing that I would really recommend in here, it's to really use content upgrades. Now, I talked about installing a sign-up form in your sidebar, but I talked as well about these bonus strategies, and in particular, using lead pages to grow your email list faster. And if I look at the Google Analytics results here, I showed you these in the Google Analytics section of the course, that 90% of my email signups almost came from these downloads. And really, these were downloads and incentives that I had put in the body of the articles themselves. So this is the download that got the most downloads from the SEO. It's just download a PDF version of this checklist, access it offline, bring it to a team or client meeting. So it's just a content upgrade. People click on this, then they can download the PDF. And the way the tool that I set that up with is lead pages. You don't have to use lead pages, but content upgrade, that process as it's known, is amazingly effective. And imagine if I hadn't have used that, I would have got just 10% of the results that I would have got. So that is what I would really recommend you do as well. So that is takeaway number four. It's to use content upgrades. Now, the fifth takeaway comes from the copywriting section of the course. And in here, we use the AIDA formula to really structure your sales copy. And the one key takeaway that you learned here was that these aren't evenly distributed. The thing that gets the most attention is the headline. And so if you are just to work on one thing and one thing only in copywriting, that would be to practice your headlines and learn how to write headlines using the formulas that I laid out here. This is really 80 cents of the dollar. This is what really has the biggest impact. People don't share blog posts, they share headlines. This is what people discuss. So it really is worth taking your time to do some practice and use this tool that I showed you here, Write 25 Headlines, to improve your headlines. This will have the much bigger impact than tweaking maybe lectures in your course or paragraphs at the end of your post. Really, headlines are what have the biggest impact, and you can model guys like this who are doing extremely well, and you can use these 11 tips as well to write magnetic headlines. So that is tip number 5, really practice writing headlines. Takeaway number 6 comes from the SEO section of the course, where we looked at this 26-point checklist. Now, while I do recommend that for your own website, you go through all of these points, if you're looking to get results extremely fast from SEO and really getting traffic from the search engines to your site, this bonus tip that I included right at the end is the way that you can really get the benefit of SEO extremely quickly. What you wanna do is leverage the high domain of other websites to quickly to get to the top of the search results. So using sites like YouTube, SlideShare, Udemy, Quora, and more, they have such a high domain authority. Google really respects these websites, so any content published on them automatically gets an advantage in the search results. And you don't need any permission to publish on YouTube, SlideShare, Udemy, and Quora. Those are open. You don't need relationships like you might do for a guest post. But you really still get that same advantage that a high domain from a guest post would bring. So I showed you some of the examples of me actually doing that in real life. So Google AdWords certification. This is not a term that never gets searched. There's 14,000 searches a month for this. And you can see that the answer to this question on Quora is my answer here, which has got over 6.7K views. So I'm really skipping to the top of the search results, just jumping on the back of Quora and really leveraging their high domain authority. I did it again for SEO for beginners. It gets 1,300 searches per month. And you can see down on the bottom here, using YouTube, I've got to the first page of Google as well. Here's one more example, Google AdWords certification course, which gets 140 searches per month, but these are high value searches. And you can really see that I've used Udemy here once again to get to the first page of Google. So that is really tip number 6, is to leverage high domain authorities to get to the top of the search results. Now, the 7th takeaway really comes from YouTube. And if we look into YouTube, you started to understand how the platform works and also what are the most important metrics on the platform. And you learned that watch time is golden. Really getting people to watch your videos is key, because that's what drives the discoverability and rank of the videos. If YouTube can see that your videos are getting watched, then they're going to really promote your videos, suggest them to other people, and that's how you can get a lot more views on your videos. Now, in order to get watch time, it's really the first 30 seconds that have the biggest impact. I showed you some of my analytics here, really showing that after the first minute, you know, a lot of people have dropped off already. It's down from 100 to almost 50% after the first 30 seconds. So those first 30 seconds are absolutely critical. If you can't retain your audience in the first 30 seconds, then you're gonna have much lower watch time overall. So you can see even in this video, it's something that I need to work on. But that's really what you gotta consider. How can you hook them in the first 30 seconds so that they can really keep watching your videos? That's the 7th takeaway for YouTube. It's the first 30 seconds that are most important. Now, the 8th takeaway from this course, really from the Facebook marketing section, is really to take advantage of the main benefit of Facebook and marketing on Facebook, and that is really to leverage other people's social network. So this is what it's all about. The average Facebook user has 200 friends, so you really need to think about how can I get and leverage the social networks of other people. And looking at my Facebook page here, we looked at really setting up a competition as a way to incentivize people to comment and to share posts with other people. So I suggested that people could tag a friend if they wanted to win that free ticket with them. They didn't have to do that to enter, but they could do it to really tag a friend who was interested in getting that second pass. And you can see that a lot of people really did this here in the post. And what it really did is allow me to get into other people's views. So you can see people linking off here to their friends, tagging them in. And that is really them doing the marketing for me. Yes, there's an incentive for them to do that, but that's really how you can leverage other people's social networks to gain exposure for your business and to relevant people as well, because they're suggesting, hey, you should check this out. I think you'll find this interesting. So these are not just visitors and people that are not connected or wouldn't be relevant. It's really a trusted source here that is recommending your business. And that is the key thing and the key benefit of Facebook. So takeaway number 8 is to leverage people's social networks. Now, looking at takeaway number 9, it's from the Twitter marketing section of the course. And if there's one thing that I would really recommend from here, it is to really use this strategy that we talked about here, the poster boy strategy. Because this incorporates a lot of the best features and ways that you can use Twitter, really using that mention feature, so you're skipping that real-time feed and you just include their username in your tweet. They're going to get a view of that in their notifications tab, and that really extends the shelf life of your tweet and gives it more exposure. And in order to mention people effectively, even people you don't even know, is to use this poster boy formula that we talked about and really showing the results that you got from reading their blog post, from taking their course, from using their service. That's a reason for you to really reach out and a reason for them to retweet you, because everybody wants to share these mini testimonials. Who doesn't want to look good and share news about someone else saying how great their course was? People are really screaming out for testimonials, so you can give them to them on Twitter, and they're really going to reward you for it by retweeting you out. So for Twitter, the key takeaway is really to use this poster boy formula. Takeaway number 10 comes from the Quora marketing section of the course, where you really learned how to build and become an authority and drive long-term website traffic. And if there's only one thing that I would really recommend you do within Quora to get results, that would be really to structure your answers. So we talked about that in point number 4 of our 7 points that we looked at, and really structuring your answers for maximum clicks. There are a lot of competing answers on Quora, but you can see that the ones that consistently get to the top are the ones that are well structured. You really kind of have like a headline, then an image to grab attention, and you have then all of the points that you have written out, and you're breaking them up with bolding, using bullet points, and finally giving that incentive for people to click back to your website. You can't give it all away in your answer. You need to give a reason for people to click back to get more tips, more free samples, etc. So in terms of winning in Quora, getting to the top of big questions like this, you really need to structure your answers to make it easy for people to see, yes, this is the best answer to the question. As a result, they're going to upvote that. But if it's a big block of text, they're not going to take time to read it. So if you're going to do one thing on Quora and focus on, it's really structuring your answers. That's takeaway number 10, really structure your answers on Quora. Now, takeaway number 11 is from the Google AdWords section of the course. And if there's only one thing that you learned out of this section, it would be really not to listen to Google. Never take their advice within Google AdWords. What you've got to remember is that they're an advertising company. Their number one goal is to get you to spend money. So all of the default ad settings are not optimal. That's why I've really recommended the settings that you take, the 10 steps here, so you really don't waste money and result in unprofitable campaigns. Really, all of the tips designed here were designed to get you to setting up your first profitable campaign. The first part of that whole process is not listening to Google, because you got to remember, they're an advertising company. They're a public company. They have shareholders. Yes, they have a friendly image, but you've got to remember that you just got to be careful in there and follow the guidelines that I've laid out. So that is takeaway number 11 for Google AdWords. Don't listen to Google. Now, takeaway number 12, the final takeaway from the Google Analytics section of the course. And I think the most important thing that I could really say to you here to wrap up is, yes, I've given you all the process. I think you understand how important it is to measure things. But the one thing that you should really do to get maximum results out of Google Analytics is set up a schedule for Google Analytics. I really showed you how to set up a monthly schedule to review your analytics using this audit. Then within Google Analytics as well, I showed you how to set up that weekly email, sending you out that dashboard. And then finally, I showed you how to set up those custom alerts so that if you have a spike in traffic or a drop in traffic, you get notifications of those. So if you really want to get insights out of your data, you've got to set up a rhythm to come in. And that is really how you're going to improve your analytical skills and be better able to identify those opportunities for growth. So those are the 12 key takeaways from this section of the course. I really hope that you found this wrap up and conclusion helpful. I want to thank you once again for taking the course. Congratulations on reaching the end, and best of luck in your marketing efforts.